Hey, hello everyone. So in this video, I'm going to show you how to find the sum of first n natural numbers in Python. So let's get started. So here we are going to get only one input from the user, that is going to be the n, till what number we need to find the sum. Okay, so let n equal to int of input enter a number. Okay, and that's going to be the input, and here we are going to use only one for loop, which will basically iterate from 1 till that number, and we'll just have a sum to find out. So for I in range 0 till n plus 1, so here we need to be careful, because Python basically for loop ranges from 0 till this n. If you put only n, it's going to be n minus 1, so that nth number won't be calculated. So if you put n minus 1, we will be getting that n value. So we need to put n minus n plus 1, otherwise our nth number will be skipped. Okay, so it's going to be sum equal to sum plus I, that's it. And here for doing this, you need to initialize sum equal to 0 as a temporary starting value. Okay, otherwise we will be garbage or junk value will be going initially. So it's pretty straightforward. First you can have 0 or 1, that's not going to be a matter. It can be 1 also, that's not going to have any issue. So it will be 1 at first, then sum will be 1, then 1 plus 2, I will be 2, so sum will be 3, and 3 will be over here. 3 plus 3, sum will be 6, 6 plus 4, it will be 10. It's just straightforward. So if I just print it down, print sum, just run it. There is also another method, okay, much simpler than this. I will show you that also. If you just print it, enter a number, I'll just enter 5. Okay, 5, it's 15, I guess. So it's 15, that's fine. And let me enter another also to check whether it's working perfectly. 7. So for 7, it's going to be 15 plus 6, 28. Okay, so 28, that's fine. And this is one method. So I will just also show you another method. Okay, I'll just put alter. Okay, alter method. So this for loop method basically takes big O of n, okay, as a time complexity, because this for loop runs n times, the where n is the nth term till the user wants to find the sum. So by this, another method is a formula method. So where the user can find just by using a formula. There is a formula, okay, if you aren't aware, there is a formula to find sum of first n numbers. So I will do that. So let me have f sum. Okay, f sum will be the formula sum. So it's going to be n is the from the user n asterisk n plus 1, okay, n asterisk n plus 1 double slash f2. If you put single slash, we will be getting the float numbers, so we need to put double slash by 2. So just again same thing, print f sum. So we'll just copy it, paste it over here, and put just run it. So it's very simple, n into n plus 1 by 2, that's the formula. It's just a straightforward formula. So this will run in big O of constant space, because it's just a formula, there isn't any loops, so it's going to take only constant time. But here we are, this is much more optimal. And in case if they ask you this question, you need to always do this one, because everyone can do this, but only if you knows this formula. So it will be really giving you a good impression. So if I just run it now, I will just run this code now, I will enter a number. So we're getting the same answer over here. If I so you enter some other number also, I guess. Put 100. So we're getting the same answer. So that's it. I hope you have found this video useful. And my name is a programming channel. I have rendered this in C, C++, Java, Python, more other videos in Python and Blender, that is 3D animation and Unity. So it'll be really great if you could check out other videos of my channel. Subscribe and support me. And thanks for watching.